Hey, what's up, everybody? I'm here to give you guys my review of The Walking Dead Season 6, Episode 5, and this episode is called Now. Now, yes, you may have seen this video up for like months on this channel. I did this video back on September 1st, 2017. Well, basically what happened is I just went back and rewatched the video since I was redoing The Walking Dead episodes, and I found out that video, you can't hear me at all because it has no audio, which sucks. So that video has been up for a year and no one's really been able to hear me. So I'm redoing that video. I deleted it off the YouTube channel and everything. I really wanted to have done a new episode, but I got to go back to the old. I just watched the most recent episode, and luckily that doesn't really give anything away from this episode. So I'm happy about that. So I'm going to get right into this episode. Now, basically how I'm going to break down these Walking Dead reviews, I know typically I've done it differently before, but basically what I'm going to do is instead of going over, because I know typically it has like a lot of storylines on it, instead of doing, and I try to do every scene in the order as if they happen, well, because there's so many other storylines, I'm just going to kind of talk about that set storyline that they have going on all at once, and obviously I know it kind of takes us through the whole episode, but it's just, I feel like doing it the other way just kind of has me jumping all around in topics, so it makes the video come out kind of sloppy, so I'm not really going to break it down that way. But yeah, let me first go over when the episode came out and everything. I'm not really going to break down who wrote it and directed it just because of the fact that, it's always different. And I'm not really going to waste the time. I'm assuming it's the same people every time, but I'm just not here to talk about that. But this episode came out on November 8th, 2015. And the episode starts off with... how does it start off? I don't really remember that, actually. Like the actual starting of the episode. I believe it starts off with Deanna looking up over the wall and kind of looking at the carnage after the wolves came in and attacked Alexandria. And you see Rick come back, and this is after he had been trapped in the OV with all the walkers piled on him, which really didn't make any sense because he was in like a no-win situation there, and they just didn't even show how he got out of that. So I thought that was kind of stupid. But yeah, he runs back in to the Alexandria, and now there's like this herd of walkers there. I actually like that scene a lot. I thought that was kind of cool, and this kind of makes it look like that Alexandria is in trouble, so the citizens of the town are very concerned about their safety because they never really had to deal with walkers before. They kind of blame Rick for putting them in this situation because everything was fine before then. And yeah, Rick pretty much reveals that now they have to start changing stuff. They have to start being more quiet at night. They have to put out the lights and do everything they can to make sure that these walkers don't break through, and they have to have extra watches. And Aaron kind of defends Rick. He talks about how, if it wasn't for Rick, this could have been a much more situation because all the walkers at once could have just broken it through because they only have half of them because Daryl, Sasha, and Abraham are driving off with the other half. And you can see that Deanna is just really not in a good place. I kind of like the visual that The Walking Dead kind of used to show that. Like, you can just kind of see she's very pale now and she's just not with it. I think she's just kind of breaking over the fact that she had built this town with a vision, and her vision slowly going away after her husband's passing and after the Alexandria attack and everything. I think it's just a little heartbroken that she had this vision and it didn't happen. She even goes later on to like her map of the town and writes stuff in that she wants to put in there, but she just realized she's fooling herself. Yeah. And I overall liked that visual. I thought it was a very good visual. And I would talk about that. That's kind of like the big story of this episode. I'm going to talk about kind of like the little stories first. So one of the little stories that happened in this episode was that Carl wanted to go after I'm just going to call her Enid. I think it's like something like that. I forget how to say her name, but this is the woman that Carl kind of has a crush on. And he asks Juan where she's been. And obviously you can see Juan's not in a good place after his father was murdered. And he saw his mom murder somebody. So, Carl is very worried about her because she just went off into the wall, out of the town by herself. So then, Juan refuses to go help him, and Carl says he's just going to go out by himself, and Juan kind of uses like a guilt trip, saying that, guilt trips Carl into not going by telling him that if he does, he'll go tell his dad about it, then everyone will be looking for him, he'll just be putting the town in more danger, and I actually like that scene a lot. I don't think Juan's the best character, I think he's very bland, but I do like the interaction that him and Carl seem to have together. I think that's actually pretty cool. And then obviously he goes later on and tells Rick about it anyways. And he says he was thinking about the conversation that him and Rick had together, that he should start defending himself. So he has the interest to do so. So Rick has him shoot like a bunch of zombies that are just there as practice. Overall, I thought, I didn't think it was like the greatest interaction ever. I think you can definitely see that Juan's still kind of very new when it comes to kind of acting and stuff, at least the character, because you can kind of see like he's very nervous all the time. I think that's supposed to be his character, but whatever. Other things that happened in this episode was Denise is working on the guy that got his leg shot in episode 3 of the season. And basically his leg's all infected and stuff, and he's close to dying. Denise is just very worried about this because obviously she really hadn't been planning on being a doctor. It's just she's kind of a victim of circumstance to be in this job because they don't have anybody else to do the job. Which I kind of think is what's the most unique thing about The Walking Dead is they can get the most unqualified people to do this job in this town because they didn't really go to school for this type of crap, considering the fact that the Walking Dead kind of happened. So Tara tells her not to be afraid. Being afraid sucks, but you have to learn to deal with the fear. And then later on, Juan's mom, I don't remember her name. Cause like I said, it's been a while since I've seen it. Deanna, does like this speech about how the world actually is now. And you shouldn't be afraid of it because they see that walkers have been kind of, like some of the people that were they killed turned into zombies anyways because they weren't able to find some of them because there was just so many attackers. She kind of did this speech about how that's kind of the way the world is now. And, this kind of got to Denise, and then Denise goes and kisses Tara, which was kind of a strange scene, and she, I think, just kind of lived in the moment. She said that, the world isn't over yet, but you shouldn't be afraid to kind of conquer your fears. I guess that's going to be kind of like the lesbian couple of the show. I'm okay with that, actually, but I thought that storyline was kind of very basic. It wasn't the best storyline. It wasn't the worst. And then the next big story that happened in this episode, I would say this was probably the biggest story that took place in this episode. And Maggie is, because we don't really necessarily know whether or not Glenn is alive or not. I mean, basically, nobody knows where Nicholas and Glenn are. But we know Nicholas is dead because we saw him shoot himself. But obviously, because nobody else knows it, it didn't really tie into the episode. It kind of ties into the episode. And because Glenn said that he would leave a signal, and we saw earlier in the episode, Michonne and Heaton, I don't even think that's his name, but I'm just gonna go with that's just the first name that popped into my head. They kind of tell her that everything that happened with Glenn in episode 3, except the fact that they don't even know he's dead, but they said that he would leave a signal. And I do kind of like in The Walking Dead, the little touches, is that they kind of symbolically show it, but they don't really actually show like a full thing of them telling us. They kind of have, you know, we kind of have to figure out how people kind of feel themselves. So I like that a lot. So, yeah, basically, Maggie wants to go out of the wall and find Glenn, because they've written names of people that have passed away, because there's a lot of people that passed away doing that Alexandria attack. And Aaron catches her. He acts like he's trying to talk her out of it by revealing that something could go wrong, like if you sprained your ankle coming down, then a zombie could stop you. So Maggie's not hearing it, and I gotta charge my computer because I didn't think I was gonna need to charge it. This is just great, fantastic. This is why we go unedited. This is why you always check your computer when you recorded one of these videos, if you're just filming it straight off your laptop. I really hope the webcam doesn't shut down on me, because this webcam's overly sensitive. This is fantastic. You know, I've been doing this for like almost like, you know, about 6 years, and you would think I would pick up on this stuff, but nope, I didn't pick up on any of this stuff. This is why we go unedited. I'm unedited. But anyhow, let me just get back to what I was talking about. And it's not charging because I didn't plug the thing in all the way. Okay, now it's officially charging. So I apologize for that. Let me make sure this video is still recording. It is. Great. This video is just so cringeworthy. But anyhow, let me just finish talking about it. See, basically what happened is I didn't really watch this episode in advance again, just because of the fact that, I didn't really plan on it because I watched the next episode. I watched this episode, luckily, though, on Sunday, so I kind of really remember everything that happened. I'm kind of reading along with the guide at the same time, so this is just great. Great footage. But anyhow, Aaron's wants to help her because he feels guilty because he's left so many people behind that he kind of wants to make up for it. So instead of going over the wall, they're going to go under the wall, because we found out that this house had a sewer built from the town that was there before, so that kind of leads them out of the wall, or out of the town, I should say. So they go down there. One visual I love from this is the zombies that were down there. I thought they really made a good job, because obviously because they were in a sewer, they were very rusty. So when Maggie tried to murder them, they couldn't because they were all hardened and rusted. I thought that was a great visual. And Aaron gets hit in the head by the a ladder that was there before, so he has to go get Maggie wants him to go get stitches, but because of Aaron's guilt, he wants to continue helping her. And they're about to go out, but Maggie doesn't want to. Maggie basically just wanted to go out there to see if Glenn was alive or not. And we find out that she's pregnant, so that's why she wanted to see if Glenn was alive. We find out that she was pregnant, which I thought was actually the biggest the biggest takeaway from this episode. And now she has to live with the fact that she doesn't know whether or not Glenn is alive or not. And she also feels bad that she had him burn the one picture that he had of her, because they thought they were never going to be separated again. And she also tells Aaron that he has to live with the fact that he left people behind. And then she's very upset. I thought this was a really powerful scene. I think this was the best part of the episode, and I thought that was good. And then, obviously, the end off the episode, Maggie cleans off Nicholas and Glenn's names, because they want to have hope that they're still alive. And I thought that was great. I thought this was a great part of the episode. This was definitely the biggest up of the episode, because I think without this story, this episode would have been very flat. But it was the highlight of the episode. Now something tells me, I please don't spoil this on me, or that comment will get removed, that Glenn is somehow, some way alive, because I don't think they would really play up on this as much in the story. Typically, if somebody's dead in The Walking Dead, they're typically dead. There was that one instance with Sophia in season 2, but because we didn't actually physically see Glenn die, I think this is a part of a bigger storyline later on to come. I know it's very tough. It really doesn't make any sense if Glenn is alive because he was just pummeled by zombies. But then again, Glenn has gotten out of like the strangest situations. He was beat the crap out of and left almost for dead by Nicholas and somehow survived. So I think Glenn's somehow alive. I don't know how he survived, but I think like they would have shown him getting eaten by the zombies or something. I think this is just a plot device to kind of make us think that he is dead and the Glockendead's trolling us. So that's, I think, was what's happening. All right, but let me talk about the next big story that came out of this episode. I actually forgot about this, but obviously the town's very concerned because they don't really think they're going to have very long to live because there's just a ton of zombies out there that are going to gear up to break into the town and just murder them at some point. So they want to just take a ton of food. And Spencer gives like this big powerful speech about how they have to... I don't want to say fast. I can't think of the word, but I'm just going to say that they basically have to conserve the food. I don't think that's the word I'm looking for, but that's the word I'm going to use. And he talks about, you know, how he was the one that kind of kept the town safe because he ended up shooting the wolf guy, when he went, to drive through the wall, and had he not shot him, which is true, he would have, the town would probably not be standing. And then we found out that speech he gives was all bullshit because when Diana goes downstairs in the kitchen, we found out he took food from the pantry and he has been drinking. So he goes off on her and blames her for the attacks and the death of their father and stuff. Well, his father anyways. So I thought that scene was great. And Diana's just basically gone. She's just lost it. So when she goes to return the stuff to the pantry, a zombie tries to come murder her, which we found out was another one of the attackers that wasn't found. And basically, she just reveals that she's not the fit leader to run this town anymore. Rick's the best guy to lead it, so she makes Rick the leader of the town. I thought that was a good part of the episode. So yeah, that's definitely an up. I know I'm doing like the up-down method, but whatever. The biggest down of the episode, I guess I would say, was obviously the stuff that happened with Denise and Tara. It just really wasn't very good, and it just wasn't all that interesting. And I just don't really care for Juana as a character, so that was also another down of the episode. So, two ups, two downs. Then obviously, I thought the biggest up obviously was the Maggie stuff. Another up of this episode definitely was obviously how kind of Deanna's kids are kind of adjusting towards the way the world is now. One of them won't even go out of the room because of how different things are. Obviously, Ron. And basically what happens is Rick and Deanna finally get together. We knew it was going to happen. I just think it was a matter of if and when. And it finally happened. Overall, I thought that was a kind of a good culmination. And then also we found out another thing that we saw blood trickling down from the ladder when Diana walked away. So, yeah, obviously that's leading to a bigger thing. Overall, I thought this episode was a decent episode. I probably didn't cover everything that it needed to cover. And I know this episode was very unorganized, obviously. I was actually going well until I had to plug my computer in. So that's awesome. But overall, I thought this was a decent episode. I think typically this was supposed to be kind of like a, kind of a slower episode just due to the fact that the first four episodes were so good. I don't really think they wanted to give away everything all at once. So this episode was supposed to be like an aftermath episode after everything that happened in the first few episodes. So I think that's kind of what was supposed to be. It didn't really need to be anything special. I do kind of like the Glenn storyline they have going on, and I think this was a good episode. I thought this was a decent episode. I'll definitely give it a 6 out of 10. I thought it was decent, but that's basically it, guys. I'm going to review the next episode now, which is the episode I actually watched, so I'm not going to do any plugs. So that's basically it, guys. Talk to you later.